Hello my dear students, in the previous class we have learned what is meant by orbit, what are various types of orbits. So what is meant by satellite orbit, what are different types of orbits, for example low earth orbit, medium earth orbit, geostationary earth orbit and inclined orbit, polar orbit, etc. we have learned in the previous classes, as well as what is the distance from the surface of the earth to the low earth orbit, what are the applications of low earth orbit. So like that we have studied each and every orbit in detail. Today we will see few more topics. Okay, the first one is frequency allocation. So every satellite will communicate to the ground station through micro frequencies only, that is from 0.3 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. There are few regulatory boards which are used to control or which are used to monitor the frequency axis of the satellites. For example, IFRB, International Frequency Regulation Board, CCIR, International Radio Consultative Committee, CCITT, International Telegraphy and Telephony Consultative Committee, and ITU, International Telecommunication Union. These are the few regulatory boards, okay, which are used to regulate the axis, the frequency axis of the satellites and the ground stations. Next one is satellite services. There are so many excellent satellite services. For example, fixed satellite service, that is all the TV signals comes under fixed satellite service. The second one is broadcast satellite service, DTH and live programs. Mobile satellite service, that is land and aeronautical mobile. Navigation satellite service, that is for radio and marine navigation. Meteorological satellite service, that is for weather forecasting. So these are the few satellite services, okay, which are used in our day-to-day life. There are few popular frequency bands which are used by the satellites. For example, C band, Ku band and Ka band. C band range is 4 GHz to 6 GHz. Ku band range is 12 to 14 GHz. And Ka band is 20 GHz to 30 GHz. If you see, the 4 GHz of C band is the downlink frequency, that is the frequency of the signal which is transmitted from the satellite to the ground station. Always the downlink frequency is less than the uplink frequency. Uplink frequency means the frequency of the signal which is transmitted from the ground station to the satellite. Next we will see the block diagram of the satellite communication system. You can see that the block diagram of the satellite communication system. You can see here, so it is the user, on both ends consists of the user, okay. So say one user wants to transmit, for example you take mobile application, okay. One person want to talk to another person who is in another country, okay. So he uses the mobile phone handset, okay. The nearby terrestrial system will send the signal to the earth station and the earth station will transmit the same signals to the satellite. These same signals are again retransmitted by the satellite to the another earth station which is present in the same or another country. This earth station will transmit the signal to the particular terrestrial station, terrestrial system located near the user. This terrestrial system will be transmitting the signals to the second user, okay, who want to communicate with the first user. This is the end-to-end communication which can be done using satellite. The same satellite can transmit, okay, signals from one particular earth station to n number of earth stations, n number of terrestrial systems. For example, TV live programs. TV live programs, okay, the broadcasting station can transmit the same live program to n number of stations all over the world through satellite. Okay. Next, what are the advantages of satellite communication? There are very, very good advantages of satellite communication. That is larger coverage area, because satellite is located at the space, which is located from 1000 to some 35,000 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. So it can cover lot of area present on the Earth to transmit the signals. So larger coverage area, the bandwidth is high. The next, global coverage and global communication. Due to this larger coverage, global communication and global coverage and global communication happens. Next, full international roaming to the mobile communication. Next, high transmission capability. The next one is point to one, multi point, one point to so many, one station to so many X stations you can transmit the signals. Satellite to satellite transmission is also exist. So one satellite to another satellite, the communication can be established precisely. There are few disadvantages of satellite communication. Okay, what are those? Launching the satellite into the orbit is very, very costly. Okay, launching the satellite into the orbit is very, very costly. It cannot be done by a normal human person. Okay, so it needs a lot of financial support from the government. Okay, next, there is longer propagation delay. Next, detecting the problems in the satellite after launching into the space is very, very difficult. Detecting the problems after launching the satellite into the space is very, very difficult. These are few disadvantages of a satellite communication. Next, let us see the comparison of the satellite communication with existing optical communication. Okay, because in the previous semester we have studied optical communication. Okay, it is also very high speed of communication system. Okay, because light is the medium through which the information is being transmitted. Okay, so let us see the difference between satellite communication and optical communication. So in satellite, if you see the satellite communication, electromagnetic waves carry the information, but in case of optical communication, light can carry the information. Next, antennas are required in satellite communication. No antennas are required in optical communication. We are establishing then one source and optical detector, and between which we are laying an optical fiber cable. No need of any antenna, but satellite requires antennas. Okay, launching and maintenance cost is very high in satellite communication. The launching of the satellite, maintaining the satellite for 10 years or 15 years or 20 years, okay, it is very expensive. Whereas optical communication, the installation cost is very low. It takes around some 1000 to 3000 rupees per user. Okay, lifetime of the satellite is around 10 to 15 years, whereas lifetime of the optical system, communication system, is 15 to 20 years. Next, point two, the important point is point two multi-point communication is possible in satellite communication. This is very important. Whereas in optical communication, point to point, one point to another point communication only we can establish in optical communication system. These are the differences between the satellite communication and the optical communication system. Next, future trends of satellite communication. Future trends means here the growth of the satellite communication, starting from the first satellite that is being launched, that is from the Sputnik onwards. Okay, so let us see what is the growth. Okay, so power generation of the satellites have been increased significantly. Next, launch and spacecraft reliability has improved. lifetime of the satellites are increased. Actually, earlier the lifetime was around 4 years or 5 years only. Now it is around the maximum of 15 years. Okay. So solid state technology, that is semiconductor technology, with the rapid growth of semiconductor technology, the size and cost of the ground stations have been reduced. Okay. Next, DTH is a trademark. You see the DTH every day now, all the people are using DTH. DTH is the trademark of a modern satellite communication system. Okay, these are the trends or improvements or growth we observed from the first satellite onwards, okay, till today. There are few applications also, okay, so of the satellite communication, as we already discussed in the earlier class. Once again we review. So what is the best application every common man is utilizing is, that is weather forecasting, floods forecasting, okay, storms forecasting. All the weather forecasting news we obtain from the TV channels, okay, so is from satellites only. Okay, so satellite takes the pictures and it will send earlier. Next, radio and TV broadcasting. Every person is utilizing the radio and TV services. Next, military services. Next, navigation, global communication, connecting the remote areas. These are the best applications of satellite communication, which are utilized by almost all the people or the human beings, okay, till now, okay, efficiently. Now let us review what we learnt in the today's class. In today's class, we have studied about satellite communication system. Satellite communication system block diagram consists of user, terrestrial system, earth station, uplink to the satellite, and from satellite onwards, downlink to the earth station present on the another region or another country. Next, terrestrial system connected to the earth station, and next, user connected to a particular terrestrial system. This is the basic block diagram of the satellite communication system. Advantage of the satellite, what are the advantages? Larger coverage, bandwidth is high, global communication is possible, international roaming to mobile phones is possible. Next, point to multi-point communication is possible. Next, satellite to satellite transmission is very easy and precise. Okay, then what are the disadvantages then? Disadvantages are launching the satellite into the space is very expensive, propagation delay is very high. Next, detecting the problems after launching the satellite into the space is almost difficult. Okay, so these are the few disadvantages. Now let us see the comparison of the satellite and the optical communication system. Satellite requires electromagnetic waves to carry the information. Optical communication requires light or photons to carry the information. Satellite requires antennas. Optical communication system doesn't require any antenna, it requires only optical fiber cable. Next, launching and maintenance cost is very high for the satellite. The installation cost is very low for optical communication system. Lifetime of the satellite is around 10 to 15 years, whereas for optical communication system is 15 to 20 years. And point to multi-point communication is possible in satellite communication, and point to point only communication system possible only in optical communication system. What are the future trends of the satellite communication? Here future trends means we are talking the growth of the satellite communication from the initial days onwards, that is from the first satellite, that is Sputnik onwards. So power generation of the satellite have been increased significantly. Launching and the spacecraft reliabilities have improved. Next, lifetime of the satellite is increased to 15 years. Solid state technology reduces the size and cost of the ground station. DTH is the best example or the trademark of a modern satellite communication system. What are the applications of satellite communication system? Weather forecasting, radio and TV broadcast, military service, navigation, global communication, and connecting the remote areas. These are the good applications of the satellite communication system. In the next class, we'll come with a new topic, an interesting topic. Okay, thank you.